Ayo, before I get into this video, no, I'm not gonna do like the typical tutorial thing where I talk for 10 minutes and then the last 2 minutes I show you exactly what to do. This ain't that. But I just want to say at the top right of the screen, you know, above me up there, you know, not only is there little like social media little ads rolling, you should check those out. Links in the description are actually below for that, but there's also a little eye icon, little pop-ups on YouTube that are happening up there. Ooh, fancy post-production, you know. There's actually a video that I will put in there that is a prequel to this video, and to some degree this is the sequel to it some way, but also other videos if you'd like to check out those videos, because I'm also on a website called Edit It. I'm probably not gonna put that link in the description, so you might have to Google that if you want to, but it's a website that was created by a YouTuber, I think just him, Mr. T Lexify. He's a Call of Duty Zombies YouTuber, but it's a website where you can either ask for a thumbnail artist, a script writer, a YouTube or a editor, if you have the money, or you can put your own, you know, your own self out there and be like, hey, this is my price, I will make YouTube videos for you, etc., etc. Free ad. The main reason I'm saying that is because I'm on there, and maybe, you know, if you watch some of those videos up there, like them, maybe I could help you with your journey just a little bit, because I'm also, I don't know how much time I'll be able to do that, because I am also doing daily uploads. I've been doing it for the past week or two, like two and a half, you know, daily uploads lately. It's taxing, it's a lot, but, you know, I wouldn't mind, you know, jumping in and helping someone else out for, you know, a good price, because I need money. Secondly, leave a like, comment, and subscribe. Greatly appreciate it if you do, but if you don't, subscribe, I hate you. If you don't leave a like, I don't like you. If you don't leave a comment, it's probably for the best, because no one likes you. You're boring and lonely. Who would reply to you? Nobody. You're terrible. 's definitely for a beginner. You know, if you're an expert watching this and thinking you're gonna learn something, and even if you do, you're not an expert. What's wrong with you? You trash. You think you're gonna learn something good from me? Look at me. Look at this. You think someone with a green screen like this is gonna give you good content and you're gonna have a good time and become a pro and get a million subscribers? What are you, some kind of stupid? Anyway, for the beginners out there, I am here to assist you in the complications and little tips that I got that I've discovered along the way for the past, I don't know, year, couple of years that I've been on this. This is, of course, for Adobe Premiere Pro. If you can't afford that, why are you watching this video? Get a job. But there is also a free subscription, or not subscription, sorry, I'm dyslexic. There's also a free editing software called DaVinci Resolve Black Magic. I think it's Black Magic, something like that. It's pretty good. I'm not putting that in the description either. You can Google that and find that pretty easily. You know, DaVinci, you know, Leonardo, Resolve, like my depression will never be resolved. Black Magic, The Gathering. You know, so let's just jump in. I'll give you some quick tips, you know. So new project, also from tutorials. There's actually a pretty good tutorial guide that does stuff in like 1 minute. They're great. If you actually need something specific and you know it, go there. Why are you watching this video? But lightly, light. Here, you know, you type your name. So I don't know. New video, you know, I'm gonna use this later. Also here, this is where your raw projects will appear. I recommend this not on your physical hard drive or like your main hard drive, but your secondary, if your computer has that. If you don't have that, then you have no choice. But I've ran into a lot of problems having that on my normal thing, etc. You know, these are just some clips they give you for free. I've never used any of them. This I ignore. I would recommend you to ignore, because I used it once and it just didn't work out. I didn't like it. So let's hit create. All right, wow, it's so quick. Your screen, I think, will look like this. If it doesn't, I'm sorry. A lot of, you know, there's a lot of tutorials where their screen does not look like how your screen looks, and it pisses me off. And if this is happening to you, I apologize. But you can, you know, change all this. You can do view, window. And then this is a bunch of things you can, like, turn on. You know, effects controls and stuff. You can turn all these on. You're these are all little things. There's this workspaces. Yes, workspaces. I use essentials. But learning, you know, these are like presets that will change this whole thing. So that's something nice for you. Congratulations. So what you want to do is do right click before you make your video. Like, oh, you can't drag anything here or anywhere. So you want to do this. You want to do new item. All this. Don't know what it does. The sequence is what you want to click on. These ain't got a clue. That's your fault. Sequence. Now, as you can see, I have 1440p. I have two of them because, you know, I had a computer before and I made this. And then I got a new computer, which I'm using now, and this was gone. So then I made this. I remade it. And then when I remade it, this reappeared. Technology does that, especially stuff on Premiere Pro or, you know, Adobe garbage. This nonsense happens a lot, at least for me. And it's probably gonna happen to you. So get ready. You're not gonna have this. This is gonna be empty. It's gonna look like that, and then boom, it's gonna be empty. So what you're gonna do is go to settings. Of course, these right here are my settings for my 1440p. So if you want, you can just copy that. You know, if you know any of this stuff, maybe, you know, you're an expert. Again, why are you watching this video? I don't know any of this nonsense for the most part. Red Cinema, that's a Hollywood, like, really expensive camera. I think it's like 10K a day to use. FND Films, great YouTube channel. Miss them a lot. They actually made a movie using that, and I think a few videos, maybe. I don't remember. Anyway, so this is the, you know what, you know, it's 1440p. That's 2K. I could do 4K resolution for my YouTube videos. I just don't because I don't have a 4K monitor. So that's why I don't do it. So that's why all my stuff is at 1440p. I was even doing that before I have a 1440p monitor, and it looked okay. Also, this is the preview thing. This is where, you know, this here, this giant square is where the preview of your video will be. You know, this at 1080, if you have a crappy computer or if you're doing this on a laptop for some weird reason, you're probably gonna have to lower this to like 720 or something, hopefully. Cause this thing lags, and when it lags, it's horrendous and it's terrible. So this is my settings. You can use them. Don't hit okay. Because you're going to have, if you hit OK, you're going to have to do this every time. You're going to want to hit Save Preset and then give it a name. You know, and then description, I didn't do that. If you want to, if you want to be that intricate, good for you. Good for you. But I'm not going to save it because why would I do that? So these are my things, you know, 1440p. Again, then I could do something there, but I'm not going to. I would do it, and then, you know, I'm just gonna do it. There you go. Woohoo. That's what it looks like. And then this is a page thing. You can actually open up stuff here. I don't remember how to do it. I don't use this whatsoever, really. I just open this up and drag and drop like so. That's what I do. You can just open stuff here directly. But it takes forever in my opinion. But we're gonna go here and we're gonna go to here because I already kind of started it a little bit. I'm gonna X that out because I don't want that there. So this is my YouTube video that I'm editing. I'm actually going to edit this video a little bit on this video. And then I'm actually gonna upload this video like the day after this video that you're watching right now comes out, you know. So if you're watching this day of, the video right here that I'm editing, I'm actually going to put that the next day. So, wow. You know, how unique. I'm freaking, yeah. Anyway, some little tips and tricks right here. This might not be here for you. Toggle proxies. You should get a thing called like media proxy something. I don't really know. I've never really opened it. But to find that, it'll be in here. It's right here, proxies. And then you just want to drag it down. There's also a bunch of other things. You know, I don't use half of this stuff. The only other thing I think I added that wasn't there was this, because I like this little center thing. It's what I use, but the proxy thing, if your computer lags, you can use the proxies. which there's a way to do it. I don't remember. I apologize. There's a video you can definitely just find for it. I never use it because I don't need it. But if you need to use proxies, that's how you get that icon there for when you make a proxy. You know, you can walk through that video. It'll make a proxy. I'm saying proxy a lot, bro. I'm having a stroke right now. But it'll, in the program, it'll make proxies of your video so then you can edit. So when you toggle that on, you're using a proxy. So it's smoother, it's less space, less memory or whatever. So it shouldn't lag your system while you're editing. You can also do this here where it says full, that's the full quality. And you can go half, you know, 1/4, 1/8. As you can see, it's god awful. At least on my screen, it's god awful. It actually looks pretty good. I don't know if it actually looks good for you. I won't see that until I'm editing this video, whatever. But in my experience, even on 1/8, super blurry, like I cannot even edit this because I don't know what I'm looking at. I've had experienced moments where it's still lagged. I can't tell you why. Couldn't help you. I couldn't help myself. There's a bunch of ways to fix lag. There's like a memory thing, memory cache, your data cache that you can erase if your thing starts lagging on you. You could do that and it will like, it's supposed to not lag. Every time I've done it, it's never helped me. So just putting that out there. So this is my YouTube video. You can then do something like this. So, you know, look at that space. Cause this is a lot of dead air here. So I want to cut this so I can, you can just go here. Boom. Oh, wow. That's so fancy. And then just drag it back. Also, sometimes when you do this, like if you cut something like this and you go all the way here, sometimes it won't go all the way and it'll get stuck and you'll just have like a slight darkness section. You gotta put this thing, this little guy, all the way to the end and do that. And that will usually do it because sometimes you'll have a little like weird ass space. Adobe Premiere has a mind zone at times, bro. It's terrible. But tip number one that I will help with you with. What do I say here again?
Oh my god, Call of Duty and Fortnite.
Call of Duty and Fortnite. Oh my gosh. So let's write OMG. My font's still there. I made this whole font earlier. I filmed this a little bit actually, and I wanted to restart because I didn't like it. I'm a perfectionist. So when you do text, you can change your font. You know, there's defonts.com where you can find whatever your heart desires. Then I changed it to orange. I put a little stroke on it, and then I like a little shadow. The shadow I actually don't really like that much, so I'm actually gonna get rid of the shadow. But as you can see here, oh my god, let's just go wham, right?
Oh my god, oh my god,
oh my god, oh my gosh. So oh my god, we're gonna do this. So now I like moving objects, like I like, you know, like having an image and then like having it sway across the screen sometimes, I guess. With text has a mind, it's an, like has its own DNA. So like usually when you want anything like the video or a picture or anything, you use these, right? To move it. So like, you know, you do position. So it's in that spot. Look, there's a little diamond there and you do this and you move it there. Usually there's another diamond. Oh wait, does this, wait a minute, am I just learn, wait, no, no way, am I learning something real quick?
Oh my god,
no, see, like this doesn't work. So don't use that, never use that, because it doesn't work for some reason. I don't know why. What you want to do is right here where it says text, you want to go ba-bam, and then you scroll, and then right here, you know, you could do this. Let me actually, so let's do that, and then I don't know. Oh my god. We're gonna go, see, look there, see that blue line? See that blue line? That means it's working. So I'm gonna just do that, and then,
oh my god, call.
Yeah, there you go. Now right here, I say Call of Duty. So what? Also, what you wanna do, if this is highlighted, and you wanna do another text, and you just click here and start typing, it's gonna be connected to this one. So you wanna click off, and then click on the screen and look, boom, there's another one. I'm also pointing that way, but you can't see my fucking eye. Why are you watching this? Anyway, so new thing. What do I say? I say Call of Duty. And I'll do a little fancy and Fortnite. Fortnite. Okay, whatever. I don't care. So we're gonna put that. We're gonna do this. So I can, like, this is my middle, even though I don't even know if this is exactly middle. I think there's a ruler thing. You can do a ruler, you know, thing here. The little icon, look, that, you know, measurements. I think I used that once just to do this. I don't even know if it's accurate. Anyway, there's a little thing, little TikTok trick that I used on TikTok to gain my 7,000 followers. Lovely. What I like to do, or liked to do, because I don't really do it anymore, is I will do this. I will click here, I will start that, but I will change this from 100 to, let's do 80, right? Let's good. Let's get a little extreme. So let's do 80. Look at that, really tiny, right? Now I want to click here. Just you can kind of click anywhere. Well, no, you can't click anywhere. You got to click on that object, but basically click off of the words. And I want to hit the right key. 1, 2, let's do 3 frames. That's how you go frame by frame, you know. Also these little things, you can hit this little arrow, boom, look, now I'm right on it, and then 1, 2, 3, I'm off of it, you know what I mean? So 1, 2, 3 frames. So the 3 frames, I am going to go from this 80 all the way to 115, right? So blam, at you, right? Now I am going to do, I'm gonna click off again, click off the text and go 1, 2, 3. And then I'm gonna bring this down to 105, right? So boom, and it's gonna stationary. So it's gonna like jump at you kinda. It sometimes it looks good, sometimes it looks bad. It looks really good when you're doing a podcast, but in my experience.
Oh my God, Call of Duty.
See, look, you know, it kinda bounced, you know, it's kinda nice. You know, it's not amazing, it's not life-changing, it's really good for like TikToks, but like you know, it jumps at you, you know. If you want that, you want that, there you go.
Let's go. Let's go.
So I say
Fortnite,
and then I'm gonna go rip, and then just because I'll do it, I'll do this. Let's go, right? Let's make this stupid big. I'm gonna put this like right there, right, and then go ba-boom. Oops. I didn't know that was a thing. Like, I didn't know you could do that. Like, I'm doing the mouse wheel. I didn't know you could do that. See, like, I'm learning with you right now. That's stupid that you could do that, but so anyway, so I'll do position, and then basically, you know, after I finish saying,
let's go.
Oh. I guess right there, I guess I'll go, so that'll be the ending, and so I'll want, I gotta go frame forward, because it disappeared, and then, and I'm just gonna do this. Let's go. Oh my God. This is a terrible YouTube video. So let's see this epic ass opening that I made.
Oh my God, Call of Duty in Fortnite. Let's go.
It's beautiful. Perfect. So there's that. So also some little neat little tricks, little tips I learned. For example, if you want to put like a swivel, if you want to like, you know, let's go boom. You know, let's just do this little part. I'm dying. I died. Wow. Shucky ducky. You know, this whole part. Let's open this up. Oh, it opened up there because it was over there earlier. Let's go here. I have something that I want to add to there right there. Boom, boom, pal. Jack in my style. So what I want to do is go. No, I don't want to do that. I want to go here. There you go. This is a big ass image. Shrink it down a little bit. Bring it back up. I've actually used this recently in my wrestling video. Go watch that. So this is 17 minutes. Oh my god, this is terrible. So from here, I will shrink this down to that, right? You know, if you wanna, you know, you could do like that. You could do a basic, I don't know how to say basic 3D. Put that in there. And you can go kapow and look. You, oh, wow. Whoa. Freaking crazy. You know, like you're a reaction star. So you could do that if you really wanted to. I don't know what we're doing here.
Oh, also
master. So there's that, you know, so you could, you know, do that. Also, if you want, you can do this. You go boom, then you go here, type in, I don't know, I like typing in black, you know, because black's the best color. I'm not just talking about clothes, I'm talking about skin. But anyway, you can you know, you do that and you can change these filters. You know, maybe I want, you know, maybe I want this, you know, to be black and white for no reason. You know, so, you know, let's go. And then, like, look, that looks so great. It's like I'm watching a movie right now. And then, cinema back in the day. Ah, shucky ducky. You know, so you could do that. You can also do different colors like green. And you kind of get the same stuff. Kind of, you know, but
you don't know. You know why you don't know? Because you don't think.
I lied.
That's why.
Oh, that's why I type in black. You can definitely type in red, and then there you go. You get a lot more. So if you want to change the color, you know, little filters, I guess. You know, so that's a little thing. Also, a little green screen thing, because I've been using green screens. There's a chroma key? No, it's not chroma. It's color key. Color key. You know, you can do some green screen stuff. For example, let's go to this red, and I, do that, and then I don't like red, so, you know, as you can see, there's a little red, actually, some red's gone, here, you can actually do that, and it still didn't work. Anyway, you can use color key, but color key's not good. What you want to do is ultra key, because then that will actually do stuff, and you could do that, and look, the room's dark now. The room's dark. It's actually pretty useful. It's way better. If you use color key and stuff, it'll lag like crazy. Also, as you can see, this bar right here, it's red. That means it's not rendered. And usually, in my experience, when that bar is red, it's gonna lag here. But my computer's pretty good, so it's not lagging right here. But yours probably will, or could. So, you can fix that. If you want to like watch it, but if you're completely done, you can do a render.
This is fucking bullshit.
1 eternity later.
Sequence. There you go. Render out effects. You can do that, and it's gonna do it. My computer's quick, so it's gonna do the whole thing like that. You know, not really like you know. Boom, it's done. Look, now it's green, and it won't lag. It wasn't lagging before, but now it won't lag. But if I decide to, you know. Let's change one little frame. I want this to be a little bit higher. Boom, it's ruined, it's red, and then now your thing's gonna lag probably if your thing was lagging before. Just some info. Also, this is a big one. You know, let's add part two from this video. I could probably make two videos. I just thought of that. So, as you can see, somewhere... this video right here, boom, I want to add this, right? Whoa, what the hell? It's just the image. There's no audio. Okay, you see all this empty spot? That's from the video you're watching right now. I cut that whole part because I was guessing I was doing bad. So now I'm like, while I was editing, I'm jumping in to record this part again. Editception, whoa, insane. So as you can see, there's no audio, right? What you need is this V1 right here, you want that on. Now, I don't know why it's right here. I don't know why it's on, these are on because I can't click those. I don't know what's happening. Also, I deleted the clip and you know, I deleted it from my computer and it was in the video. So when you get this, it means you deleted a clip on your computer that was in your video. So if you want to try and you have to refind it to like make it work again, or you just hit offline and it means it's gone. So there's that. But you want this V1 on. I don't know how to turn those on. Like things just don't want to work sometimes. That's just Adobe Premiere. So now, when you put a clip in, look, there's audio. Ooh, the old man is crying. It's so sad. So the audio will be there now. So, but over time, when you keep adding clips, it'll start to do this. And now how to fix that, you could do the media cache thing and clear your media cache, but that's a hassle. What you could just simply do is, when you add a new clip like this, it'll, you know, be like, it'll be like this if it's not on. But even though it's on and you add stuff and you add more clips, it'll still do this. How do you fix it? You have to hit save. Well, delete. No, not copy. Delete. Save. Close project. I forgot I have the other one open. Close project. No. Because I don't want to save the video that I'm not even working on, right? Then you want to reopen your project. Go here. And then, wow, there's audio there, right? I don't know how to fix that. That's my fix for that. Just to let you know. I apologize that I'm not... this is spontaneous. I'm a daily YouTuber now. And I just needed content for today. So this was my content. So... those are kind of like all the tips that I felt like giving, at least off the top of my head. I only really did the beginning of this video for you. The point is, there's gonna be a lot of problems. Just deal with it, I guess, you know, just keep on trucking. If this tutorial helped you in any way, how?